मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। टुडे अगेन वी आर हियर विद आवर न्यू चैप्टर व्हिच इज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर बुक नंबर 2, दैट इज पॉलिटिकल थ्योरी एंड इंट्रोडक्शन। एंड द सब टॉपिक्स व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर टुडे आर पॉलिटिक्स एंड पॉलिटिशियंस। स्टूडेंट्स, अंडर दिस सब टॉपिक वी विल कम टू नो अबाउट द पॉलिटिकल फील्ड एंड देन आफ्टर दैट वी विल कम टू नो अबाउट द पॉलिटिशियंस। हु आर पॉलिटिशियंस and how do they perform their responsibilities as a politician. Second subtopic is role of politicians. Students, under this subtopic we will come to know about the various responsibilities which can be performed by our politicians. We will come to know about these things. And the last subtopic of today's lecture is political theories. Under this subtopic we will come to know about different theories which can be very very helpful to these politicians to govern the country in a systematic way where they have only one purpose, that is to work for the welfare and goodness of the common people. So let's start with our first subtopic, that is politics and politicians. Now we are going to discuss about the political field. What is this political field? Politics. Students, to understand this political field, we have to come to know about a few points which are very important to know. Now, politics. What is politics? Politics is a kind of field or is a kind of an area where people work for rest of the citizens of the country to do good things, good tasks for the development of these common people. It's a kind of field where people work to make rules and regulations so that common people can follow them and can lead a very good and dignified life. So this field is known as politics, where few people get the chance to work for the welfare and goodness of the common people. They listen them and then try to solve their problems by making different rules and regulations, by passing different laws. So how we can understand this? In this way, it is a kind of field where few people work for the other common people for their goodness and welfare. So students, this is the easiest and the simplest definition of political field or politics, we can say. It's a kind of field where few people work for the other common people of the country for their goodness and welfare. So this field is called politics, with the help of rules, regulations, by framing different laws, by framing different policies or schemes so that these common people can enjoy their life equally, we can say, or freely. Now we are moving towards our next point, that is politicians. Students, I think nowadays in this modern society everyone knows who can be a politician. So who can be a politician? The person who has interest in political field, who wants to work for the welfare and goodness of people by becoming the part of government, that person is known as politician. Now, how a person can be a politician? It's also a very simple process. From previous classes, we are coming to read and study about this process. Really, that is election, where common people choose common people as their representative, and these common people, after becoming representatives, they become the part of a government and start working for the welfare and goodness of the common people. So we can write here, the persons who are chosen by the common people through election as representatives are called politicians. And students, it's also important to know that these politicians get their positions at different level. Few politicians can be MPs, few politicians can be MLAs, okay? So at different level they get their position. But the most important thing is, what is the purpose for becoming the part of government as a politician? That is to work hard for the welfare and goodness of the common citizens of the country, who give them right to be the part of government and to enjoy many privileges. Yes, students, there is no doubt that these politicians enjoy many privileges or facilities, but really they should not forget the main purpose of becoming the part of government, that is to work only for the goodness and welfare of the common people, because they trust them. They believe that yes, they are the people who can work for them. Now students, we are moving towards our next subtopic, that is the role of politicians. What do they do after becoming the part of government? Now we are going to know about that. It's also very easy. In different previous classes, we came to know about the role of government and the people of government. How do they work? What do they do for the common people? So we can write here, role of politicians. So what do they do? Let's start. First, be the part of government, they work hard with full enthusiasm. Means they have full interest to come in this political field as the part of government. So for this, they work hard. They work as a social worker first in the society, and then they become able to be the part of the government after becoming representatives when common people choose them. Second,
to frame rules and regulations for the people. Students, as in our previous lecture, we came to know about legislature, executive. These are the organs of government. So the people who become politicians and become the part of legislature. So how do they work? They frame rules and regulations for the common people so that these common people can follow them and can lead a very good life without any disturbance. Now, next is to apply these rules in the country. Now, students, the people who become politicians and become the part of executive, so what do? They have the responsibility for the implementation of all these rules and regulations which are framed by the legislature in the country, so that all the people can have these rules and regulations equally. Next, to work for the welfare of common people. Really, students, this is the main purpose of any politician, that he or she should work for the welfare and goodness of the common people. Nothing should be there more than that. Now, after that, few other functions are there of these politicians. What are these functions? What are these responsibilities? These are to maintain peaceful atmosphere in the country so that all the people, all the common people, can lead a very safe life in the country. These politicians have the responsibility to provide protection to these common people by arranging the facility of police in different corners of the country. And in this way, they can be able to have a kind of control over crime. After that, we are moving towards our next subtopic, that is political theories. Students, these theories are also very important and very easy also. For many a times we have discussed all these things. Now again we are going to discuss the same things as the political theories. Under this, we will come to know about different theories, about different sources which can be very, very helpful for our politicians to work for the common people nicely, honestly, properly. These theories help politicians to govern the country in a very systematic way. So what are these political theories? First, again, I shall tell you what can be political theories. Political theories are the kind of sources for the government people or for the politicians by which they can govern the country properly, systematically. These theories help our politicians to govern the country in such a way that all the citizens of the country can have all the facilities in an equal way. No discrimination can be there in the society. No inequality can be followed by the politicians with the help of these theories. Now let's start. First is theory of providing fundamental rights. Students, I think it's not tough for you to understand what are fundamental rights. We came to know in our second chapter about these rights. These are basic rights which are necessary for each and every person of the country to lead meaningful and dignified life. What are these fundamental rights? Right to equality, right to freedom, right to religion, right to express views freely in the society, right to raise voice against exploitation, right to education, and finally, right to constitutional remedies. Means if we are going to face any problem in the society, if our rights are going to be violated by others, we have facility of courts where we can go, we can file our case, and we can get impartial justice. So this is the theory for politicians to be followed, means to provide fundamental rights so that all the citizens can enjoy their life properly. Second, theory of freedom and equality. Students, it's similar to our first theory. Yes, all the people should have the facility of freedom. These politicians should be able to provide them freedom and equality to lead their life in a very proper way. They should have equal rights. There should not be any kind of discrimination done by these politicians on the basis of caste, creed, color, community, language, religion. All the people should be equal for these politicians who are working in political field, so that all the people can be able to have a very good life in the country. Next is theory of listening the common people and fulfilling their demand which are necessary and legal. So students, we have the third theory, that is the theory of listening the common people and fulfilling their demands which are necessary and legal. So under this theory, we are going to discuss that these politicians, they have a theory. Well, they are supposed to listen the common people. What are their problems? What kind of problems they are facing in the society? It is necessary for politicians to listen, to analyze. And finally, if they feel, if they observe that these demands, suppose they have problem, so politicians have to sort out their problem. And suppose common people are demanding for something, again they have to analyze whether these demands are legal, necessary to be followed. If yes, so no doubt these politicians will have to listen them and will have to fulfill their demands. So students, in today's session we came to know about politics, what can be the political field, and then we came to know about the politicians, who are the people who are known as politicians in our country. Then we came to know about the different functions performed by these politicians. What do they do as the responsibilities towards common people in the society? And finally, at last, we came to know about the different theories which can be followed by our politicians to govern the country in a very systematic way, where they work for the goodness and welfare of common people. So that's all for today's session. Students, we will meet again in our next session with the new subtopics for the same chapter. Till then, take care. Have a nice day.